Beat the Pundit with the Scottish Sun.
For the best football news and opinion online, thescottishsun.co.uk/football.
Right, Beat the Pundit time. Do you know you are on the edge of history?
Oh.
On the edge of glory, as Lady Gaga would say.
Yeah.
Because you could become the first pundit ever to win three times in 1 week.
Yeah.
Now, most people twice already this week.
Most people don't get the chance because you're thinking, why would you have the same pundit on three times this week?
But listen,
we needed him. We needed him to step up to the plate this week, and he's won twice.
Yeah.
Some going.
Once in a tie break.
Give him the chance of the hat trick.
Don't you try and wriggle out of it just because you've been in the Sahara Desert for the last week and you're worried that you've not brushed up. Ian is going to take part tonight. How's it going, Ian?
Good, thanks. Yourselves?
Not bad, Ian. It says you're an Air United fan. How is life going as an Air United fan? Are you over the Gordon DL years? Take a while to get over that stuff.
Yeah, we're over them. We'll now get Mr. Brown in charge, so we're quite happy down here.
Ah, two similar characters. What a result. Last time out, Dunfermline tomorrow. Can you keep that run going?
Hopefully. His first three games, Dundee United, Rafe, Partick at home, so he's had a hard run, but you can see a structure and a shape and a way of playing now makes a big difference.
Five goals, three goals, seven goals. Yeah. Are Air the new entertainers?
Well, Bruni's doing very well. He went to Ibrox in the cup tie. It wasn't the route that people were predicting. So he started very well.
Talk about the championship, though. I mean, it's always tight. It's always crazy. You look at midweek, Dundee United, their own fans furious, but Raith can take advantage either, really. Both level and 51 points, although that might be a good point because Morton were flying. Partick have had some tough results. And tomorrow for us, certainly in this part of the world, Partick, Dundee United. The Simon Donnelly derby, nobody's calling.
Well, do you know what? They've met twice this season and the aggregate score is Dundee United 8, Partick Thistle 0. But I just think that Thistle will get a bigger chance tomorrow.
That game at Firhill?
Yeah.
Oh, that's tasty.
Yeah.
Tasty.
Right, anyway, let's play. This is the big game of the weekend. Don't let anyone fool your heads. It will be the chance for the hat-trick in a week for Hugh Keevan's Tales. It will be Simon Donnelly. And the coin has taken history away from us. It is a Tales. So Simon will play. We will give him some greatest hits radio to listen to. Turn it up nice and loud. And that means it's just you and I, sort of, Ian. 30 seconds, answer as many as you can, and pass if you don't know the answer, okay?
No bother.
Good man, 30 seconds going on the clock, and your time starts now. How many Scottish Premiership sides have an artificial pitch?
Two.
Which team is currently second in the Scottish Championship?
Rafe.
Which Scot manages the Tampa Bay Rowdies?
Pass.
What trophy did Kenny Dalglish win as interim Celtic manager?
League Cup.
Name the only SPFL club beginning with B.
SPFL? Pass.
Who did Rangers sign James Tavernier from?
Wigan.
Who scored more league goals, Bojan Miovski or Queen's Park's Rory Payton?
Miovski.
Okay, let's bring him back. Simon Donnelly, can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
Same set of questions to you. You ready?
Yeah, go for it.
Good. 30 seconds on the clock and your time starts now. How many Scottish Premiership sides have an artificial pitch?
Two.
Which team is currently second in the Scottish Championship?
Wraith.
Which Scot manages the Tampa Bay Rowdies?
Pass.
What trophy did Kenny Dalglish win as interim Celtic manager?
League Cup.
Name the only SPFL club beginning with B.
Pass.
Who did Rangers sign James Tavernier from?
Pass.
Who scored more league goals, Aberdeen's Bojan Miovski or Queen's Park's Rory Payton?
I'll go Payton.
Okay. What do you think, Ian? Have you done enough?
I think it could be a tie.
Let's find out. How would you have done, Hugh? Does this sound difficult to you?
Have I got Bonnie Rigg Rose for the B?
Bonnie Rigg.
Spoiler. Right. How many Scottish Premiership sides have an artificial pitch? It's two. Livy and Kilmarnock. You both got that.
Right.
It would help if I had some sort of foresight and didn't advertise 30 seconds before that Raith Rovers were second.
So you
both got that as well.
Right.
None of you got the Tampa Bay Rowdies.
Is it Stephen Glass?
No, Robbie Nielsen.
It's Robbie Nielsen
there. Yeah,
Robbie Nielsen. I was wondering, what is a rowdy? Is it just as in someone who is noisy?
I think just a rowdy had something to do with the cattle drifter.
Is that recently?
No, it was a few months ago now. I don't remember. Is it just like the Tampa Bay boisterous noisy people? Guys. Is that what it means?
Back in the Wild West days, a rowdy was something to do with cattle.
Was it? See, that's why you're here. Hugh the Educator. Right, anyway, got a bit distracted there. None of you got it. We're still level. Kenny Dalglish won the League Cup. Both of you got it. Still level. Dear. The only SPFL club beginning with a B.
Bonnie Rigg Rose.
None of you got it. So we're still level. Who did Rangers sign James Tavernier from? Wigan. Ian got it.
Yeah.
It's going to be settled on a 50-50.
Wigan.
Who has scored more league goals? Aberdeen's Bojan Miovski or Queen's Park's Rory Payton?
What did Ian go for?
Ian went for Miovski.
Uh-huh.
Simon went for Rory Payton. Bojan Miovski's got 13.
Uh-huh.
Rory Payton has 14.
Yeah.
My heart breaks for you, Ian. We're going to go to a tiebreaker.
I knew it was Payton after that. Yeah, I knew it.
You're a fan. Don't turn your back on the championship. That would be my advice to you. You're a fan of the championship. Anyway. Right, we're going to go to the tiebreaker. Just wondering if we've had this question. Like, tell me we're not repeating a tiebreaker, or is it just that we've...
But Simon's been in the desert anyway, so...
I think they're all on along a similar theme recently. I think that's why. We might need to mix it up, or people are going to start predicting the tiebreaker. How many games have the Scotland men's team won? Ever. Simon Donnelly, write it down.
Ever?
Yeah. How many games have the Scotland men's team won? Write it down. What I've noticed about these questions is people are getting them miles out. Go on, let's see. Write it down. Okay, that's fine. Right, what are you going for, Ian?
230.
230. Simon Donnelly says...
450.
Oh, don't make me do this arithmetic.
Because the thing is... Somewhere in between.
Yeah, you'll find that it is really simple, but just because the pressure's on them now working right... What have you said, Simon?
450.
Right, okay, so... Right, and what did Ian say again?
230.
Right, that's fine. Even I can handle that arithmetic, not to worry. The answer is 388. Simon Donnelly gets it. Nothing worse than a tiebreaker win for the pundits on a Friday night, Ian. Hard lines.
Stole it.
Good man, Ian.
Thank you.
Well played, Ian. All the best, mate.
There we go.